Hello, my name is Keshwani.
That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani.
We are here because we want to improve our vocabulary. Today we will have our lesson number
105.
The words that we're going to learn today are going to come from page number 30 of this book that I'm holding in my hand here, the RN pre-entrance nursing exam. The words in this exam that they're testing are the exact same, well, not the exact same test, words, but are of the same caliber, of the same level, the vocabulary that is, that one is likely to encounter in any of the other tests, whether you're preparing for GRE or GMAT or SAT or SAT or TEES, whatever it is that you're preparing for, the words that we're going to learn in these videos are going to be helpful to you in raising your scores. It will help you improve your score. Let's begin on that note.
Let's begin, shall we?
The very first problem that we're going to do is problem number 9, as I said, from page number 30. Here's what the problem says. It says,
Our mayor has always been open and honest. Our mayor has always been open and honest. He speaks.
And then here's the word that we have to fill in here in the sentence to finish it. Among the four answer choices that are given there, and the right answer here is
the word that you will find in 9C, and the word is candidly. He speaks candidly. Candid would be the adjective. This is the adverb. Candid.
What does it mean?
It's a word that we have already learned on day number 10.
If you type in vocabulary words day 10, you will find that we have already learned it. So we're going to go through it rather quickly.
It means exactly what I said. It means to be open and honest. It means to be open and honest. It means to be straightforward. If you're straightforward, if you're open and honest, such a person is said to be candid. The synonym would be above board. Again, this is something we learned on day number 5, and I believe
that I explained on day number 5 the etymology of the word above board, that is, and I'm not going to go there right now. If you're interested in learning it properly, just watch the videos. As I said before many times, we cannot keep repeating the same words over and over again. Above board we learned on day number 5, candid we learned on day number 10. Here's another synonym.
It means to be without shenanigans. Without shenanigans. Again, we learned that on day number 33.
Shenanigan. Without shenanigan. Again, if you're interested in learning it, watch day number 33.
It means without trickery.
That was it. That was number 9. And the word was candid, which means to be open and honest, to be straightforward, to be above board, to do things what you're supposed to do without shenanigan, without trickery, without funny business. That was question number 9. Now let's learn a couple of other words that we find in question number 9 in the other answer choices, beginning with answer choice A.
And the word is cynical. Cynical. It's an adjective.
We can describe a person as being cynical or as being a cynic.
What is a cynic? Cynic would be the noun. He's a cynic.
He's a cynic. He's cynical.
Let's learn it, shall we? What does it mean if you describe somebody as being a cynic?
Or to be cynical?
To be cynical means to always doubt, to always doubt or question the goodness of mankind. To always doubt or question the goodness of mankind. To always feel that other people are up to something, that the other people are up to no good. Other people are up to no good. That they are up to something. Other people are up to no good. That's an idiom here, to be up to no good. You always feel that they are not telling you the truth, that they are not telling you the whole truth. To believe that all people are motivated by selfishness,
which is a very strange way,
very sad way to go on living.
I shouldn't have gone there, because we are not here to lecture anybody. We are here to just simply learn the words. So we won't go there. But that's what it means to be cynic. You always feel that people are up to no good. You always feel that they're not telling you the whole truth. To always doubt and question the goodness of mankind is to be cynic, to be cynical. If my car breaks down and I'm sitting on the side of the road and somebody pulls up behind me, this is the middle of the night here at 2 o'clock in the morning, I'm waiting for somebody to come, tow truck to come or something, and somebody pulls in behind me and comes to me and asks me if I need help, instead of saying, oh, what a nice person he is or what a nice person she is, I immediately start asking myself, what is he up to? What does he want? What does he really want? He must have to always feel that people have ulterior motives. That people have ulterior motives. And if you feel that, you're being a cynic. You're being cynical. Let's learn the word ulterior on the top, shall we? First thing we have to understand is that ulterior is not to be spelled with an A, it is to be spelled with a U, ulterior. Ulterior, it's an adjective. What does it mean, ulterior motive? Ulterior motive is not some other motive, as a lot of people end up thinking. A lot of people think from the context it means some other motive. It is some other motive, but that's not what the word means. Ulterior means not disclose.
It means hidden. Something that is hidden is said to be ulterior. Ulterior motive is so called because that motive is hidden. He's not telling you what he's really up to. He's pretending to be your friend. He's pretending to help you. He's not telling you the real reason why he's here.
That he's keeping that reason is hidden from you, hence it is ulterior.
Something that is not disclosed. Something that is not disclosed. Something that is not divulged. I just realized that we're going into this much detail In fact, we have already learned this word on day number 23. On day number 23, we already learned this thing. Something that is not revealed. Something that is not revealed. A motive that is concealed. Intention. A motive that is concealed, hidden, that is intentionally, it has to be intentionally in order to deceive. There you go. A motive
that you keep hidden, a motive that you do not divulge, a motive that is kept concealed because you're up to no good.
It is concealed intentionally because you want to deceive someone. In order to deceive, such a motive is said to be ulterior motive.
It does not mean other motive. It just means hidden, not disclosed, not divulged, not shared.
The last word we want to learn here is the word that appears in our choice B. 9b. Let's learn it very quickly. And the word is, we need the room obviously. The word is eloquent. It's an adjective. What does it mean to be eloquent? It means to be good at speaking. If someone says Michael is so eloquent, that means he's so good at speaking. When he speaks, people listen to him.
To have way with the words.
To have a way with words. Some politicians are like that. Some politicians are very eloquent and some are not.
It means to be persuasive, to be convincing,
to be graceful in your speech. It means to be cogent. Cogent again is a word that we learned on day number 7. Again, we're not going to go there right now. It means to have cogency.
Cogency is the noun. Cogent means to be persuasive, to be convincing. If you're persuasive, if you're convincing, the person who is persuasive and convincing is said to be cogent. Oh, what a cogent argument you make. What a cogent point you make. What a persuasive, convincing point you make. Your argument is full of cogency, which is a noun. Your argument is full of persuasiveness. Your argument is full of convincing. I don't know what the noun would be. I don't know what the noun of convince is. Persuasiveness, cogency, eloquence. Eloquence just means to be good at something. It doesn't necessarily mean to be persuasive. Do you understand? They're sort of distant relative. And the noun of eloquent would be,
eloquence. Eloquence. And the adverb would be eloquently. He spoke eloquently. His speech was very eloquent. It was full of eloquence. See you tomorrow, okay? Bye now.